optimally and have used them in varying terrains of the nation. Deployment of UAVs in different parts of the country has enabled the Indian Air Force to utilize the capability of the system in different roles, including disaster management and internal security. 2 years ago, it was employed for aerial reconnaissance of flood-affected areas close to Barmer, here in Rajasthan. The UAV is only a part of the whole system known as the Unmanned Aerial System, or UAS. UAS consists of the UAV itself, the ground control station, which houses the operator consoles, the data link system, which transmits and receives the signals to and from the UAV, and most importantly, the payloads or the cameras fitted in the UAV that give us the pictures that you see today. Though called unmanned, there is a full team of operators and maintenance crew on the ground required to operate the UAV. The operational crew consists of a mission commander, external and internal pilots, an observer, and a systems engineer. The mission commander is responsible for the overall conduct of the mission. The external pilot carries out the takeoff and landing of the UAV by standing next to the runway and flying it from outside using a remote control box. Once airborne, the UAV is handed over to the internal pilot, who is inside the ground control station. He is now in charge of flying and navigating the UAV to the required area and back safely. The systems engineer monitors the health of the aircraft and ground systems. The observer handles the payload on board the UAV. The payload, which transmits continuous video of the area being observed, can be a day camera for day images and a forward-looking infrared or a FLIR camera for night images. Use of both cameras gives the UAV a round-the-clock capability. Most of the visuals that you see today are being transmitted from both these cameras. The crew flying the UAV today are Dhari, CJ, Rajat, Maurya and Shibin. The various roles for which UAVs are utilized by the Indian Air Force are collation of intelligence through reconnaissance and surveillance, UAV assisted fighter and helicopter strikes, and laser designation of targets. Additionally, it is used for battle damage assessment and to give real-time inputs to strike aircraft during battlefield airstrike and battlefield air interdiction missions.